It was 1876. America was celebrating its centennial, brimming with patriotic fervor and optimism for the future. As railroads stretched across the frontier, new states joined the Union, and pioneers settled the western lands, the nation's eyes gazed ahead to a manifest destiny of progress and prosperity. Yet in these same western territories, a pivotal moment was unfolding, one that would end in violent tragedy and cast a shadow over America's vision of its future. Chapter 1, The Great Sioux Nation. For generations, these lands belonged to the Lakota Sioux, the Northern Cheyenne and Arapaho tribes. They moved freely across the rolling plains following the buffalo herds, living as nomadic hunter-gatherers. This was their ancestral homeland, embedded in their culture and religion. The Lakota called the region their sacred hoop, encircling their people, buffalo, and life itself.
You had a proud culture here, the Lakota Sioux and their allies, fiercely independent, deeply tied to the land and their way of life. The buffalo wasn't just their livelihood, it was the center of their spiritual world.
With America expanding westward, native tribes were increasingly confined to reservations, forced to adapt their ancient cultures. The Lakota signed treaties ceding lands, but strived to maintain control of the sacred Black Hills and the Powder River country, prime buffalo hunting territory. They would not surrender this heartland without a fight. Chapter 2, George Armstrong Custer. By 1876, one figure had captured America's imagination, George Armstrong Custer. The daring young general had rocketed to fame as the boy general during the Civil War. His cavalry exploits seemed to personify the Union's momentum and inevitable victory. But the war also bred in him a reckless hunger for glory and media attention.
Custer was a complicated fellow. He was a very brave man, there can be no doubt of that. He was also brash and certainly ambitious. And he was well known to have great vanity. He wanted to not only live the life of a soldier, but to live the life of a celebrity. That need for fame and victory gave him that life and legacy. As many of us know, that same thirst for glory would bring that life to a rather abrupt end.